I wanted to, I got into this fall unintended injuries around the holiday season. And so what had also occurred to me when I was making my list a few weeks ago about what we could address as people are going through the holidays is falls is what we focus on. And what do people suffer from the most with falls, right? Well, and what we came across is as people travel, as you're going to see loved ones, people are in new environments. And my wife actually suggested this topic. My wife works in the hospital. She works for a local hospital here in Naples. And she said, you know, we see a lot of patients in the emergency room around Christmas time who have fallen because they're in a new environment, or there's a pet that they're not used to, or there's an unfamiliar path from a bedroom to a bathroom. In fact, this Santa Claus right here almost gave my father a heart attack when they were with us last year. So it's just in front of a door. He opened the door and boom. So as you go throughout the holidays and as you go through your parties, if you're traveling this year, I just want you to take a second in your new environment. I want you to make sure that you don't have to make this a big deal. You can just make a mental note privately to yourself about where rugs are, what rugs are secure or what are not secure. Check your chairs. Make sure the chairs are out of the way. You notice at the holidays, we have a different settings and tables and chairs set up everywhere. You want to make sure you have clear pathways, especially at night as you navigate to the restroom if you're staying with children or staying with a loved one. And also in the kitchen if you're cooking. You know how things can fall on the floor. So you want to be aware and cognizant of where things are as you're moving around the kitchen or around all kind of people. I have a great sheet here again, your sources, guys. When you get your paper, you'll be able to check your sources and pull this sheet up. Again, we're not going to go through all this here in class because of a time constraint, but it does give some great ideas. Now, let's say you're a young person, as everyone here is, right? And let's say you're going to an aging parent's home. What do you look for? What do you look for if you're traveling to your parents' home or your grandparents' home, and maybe you haven't seen them in a while? I want you to just kind of do an assessment, all right? This is called the Romberg assessment. Now, some folks are just not going to have anything to do with it, but if you suspect or start noticing things about your aging parents, you know, let's say that there's a little more clutter than usual, right? Let's say that, you know, you have some loose rugs that normally aren't there. You have some clothes that aren't getting put up. Maybe you have damage to cars or garages. You know, these are just little things you want to look for as your parents begin to age, just to kind of identify maybe what state of mind or if they're at a fall risk or their chances of falling are increasing. This Romberg test, if it comes down to it, this is a neat little tool that you can use to determine if someone is suffering from a neurological disease, something like Alzheimer's, dementia. It's a simple test, all right? And you're going to want to be there. You don't want to have them do this on their own. You're going to have your parent or your loved one stand with their feet close together. You're going to have them cross their arms, right? And what I want is if it comes down to it, you're going to stand right beside them. I would suggest you have a chair behind them in case they do lose their balance. You take them right to the chair or grab them. And what we're going to do is we're going to have them close their eyes for 15 seconds. And we're just going to watch them. And let's see if they can maintain their balance. Do they look like a tree in the wind? They're swaying all over the place. Or are they nice and steady? What that is that's going to give us a bit of an indication of if they're dealing with a neurological disorder. Now, that's not a fail-safe, right? That's not an end-all, a be-all, end-all. So if they do have a positive Romberg test, which means they've lost their balance, you may want to schedule an appointment with a physician. I would do it maybe two or three times, maybe once in the morning, once in the evening, maybe once at noon. On different days, if you're spending the time and you have that opportunity, just to kind of get an idea maybe if they're more steady in the morning versus the evening. And so that's just some suggestions, guys. Any questions there? Good, good. All right.